Good morning. Welcome to worship. If any of you would like to move a little closer, I think today would be the day you could do that safely in this church. It is wonderful to see all of you. After our big Christmas Eve celebration, today is a normal day, a quiet day, and so we're glad for that as we proceed into the Christmas tide. Today's the first Sunday after Christmas. It's also the first day after Christmas. Just want you to know that the giving envelopes, if you have asked for them for 2022, are in the parlor. So if you want to pick them up after church, you can do that. There are no meetings this week for announcements.
Carmela and I will be there tomorrow, Tuesday, Wednesday. But Thursday and Friday we will close. And if you need to reach me or have an emergency, please call my cell, which is on the announcements on the telephone. So please don't feel free to call me. And let us begin worship with the introit. Join me in the call to worship that's in the bulletin. Come, people of God, let us give thanks for these holy days of Christmas. Come, people of God, let us celebrate and rejoice for the wondrous gifts given to us. Let heaven be glad and let the earth rejoice. And now we again sing the joyous carols of Christmas and rejoice in our Savior's birth. Please join me in singing Good Christian Friends Rejoice. Thank you.
join me in the prayer that's found in the bulletin. O God, whose wondrous love took the form of a little baby, we give thanks that we have been touched by the joy of his birth. Help us to carry a measure of the delight and the bounty of your love into our new day, into our new year. Take up residence in our hearts, guide us and give us courage to serve you in all we say and do. Fill us with the joy of living and the spirit of giving as we approach the new year. We pray in the name of the babe of Bethlehem. Amen. I put an affirmation of faith in the bulletin. It's actually a scripture passage from the Old Testament prophet Isaiah. So please join me in the passage found in the bulletin. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Though darkness covers the earth, and dark night is over the nations, but upon you the Lord will rise, and the glory of the Lord will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and rulers to the brightness of your dawn. No longer will violence be heard in your land, nor ruin or destruction within your borders. You will name your walls salvation, and all your gates praise. No more will the sun be your light by day, nor by night will you need the brightness of the moon, for the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Amen. May it be so. The scripture lesson comes from the epistle of Paul to the Galatians. Listen for God's word to you. But when the right time came, God sent his son, born of a woman, subject to the law. God sent him to buy freedom for us who were slaves to the law, so that he could adopt us as his very own children. And because we are his children, God has sent the spirit of his son into our hearts, prompting us to call out, Abba, Father. Now you are no longer a slave, but God's own child. And since you are his child, God has made you an heir. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Will you pray with me? O Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. We just came away from Christmas Eve, where we realized that God came to us in human form. God came to us in the ordinary of life. The extraordinary came to the ordinary. And this morning I wanted to think about the name of Jesus. If you remember in Joseph's dream, he was told to name this child, the child of Mary, Jesus. Many of the names in the Bible, though, tell us of a name called Jesus, a name that is nothing less than palatial or majestic. Son of God, the Lamb of God, the light of the world, the resurrection and the life, the bright and morning star, Alpha and Omega. In my mind, those phrases stretch the boundaries of our human mind, of our human language, in an effort to capture the uncapturable, the grandeur of God. And try as they might to draw us near, they always fall short. Hearing them is something like hearing a Salvation Army band on a street corner playing Handel's Hallelujah Chorus. It's a good try, but it doesn't work. It takes a lot more than that to appreciate that glorious music. Well, the same is true with language. The phrase, there are no words to express, is really the only one we can honestly apply to God. No names really do him justice
in our language or any other language. But there is one name which recalls the quality of the Master that bewildered and yet compelled those who knew him. It reveals a side to him that, when recognized, is enough to make you fall down and worship. It's not too small, and it's not too grand. It's a name that fits like the shoe on Cinderella's foot, Jesus. In the Gospels, it's the most common name used for Jesus. It's used over 600 times. Jesus is actually the Greek form of Joshua. That's a very familiar Old Testament name. Did you know, though, that there were 5 high priests in the temple in Jerusalem at the time of Jesus who were named Jesus? The writings of the historian Josephus refer to 20 men called Jesus. The New Testament tells us of Jesus Justus, who was a friend of Paul. Some manuscripts have the first name of Barabbas as Jesus. So when Pilate yelled out to the crowd, "Which would you like me to release to you, Jesus Barabbas or Jesus called the Messiah?" So what's the point? If it was so common, Jesus could have been called Joe. If Jesus came today, it's doubtful that he would distance himself from the likes of us with a lofty name like Your Reverend Holiness Angelic Divinity III. Doubtful. Nope. When God chose the name his son would carry, he chose a very human name. He chose a name so typical that when you're a teacher, you sometimes have 2 or 3 of them on your elementary school class roll. John said, "The Word became flesh." In other words, Jesus was touchable, approachable, reachable, and what's more, he was ordinary. If he were here today, you probably wouldn't even notice him walking through a Target store. He wouldn't turn heads by the clothes he wore or any jewelry that he flashed. "Just call me Jesus." You can almost hear him say it. He was the kind of fellow that you would invite over to your home to watch an Eagles-Cowboys game. He'd play with your kids. He'd doze on the couch. He would even cook steaks on your grill. He'd laugh at your jokes and probably tell a few of his own. And when you spoke, he'd listen like he had all the time in eternity. And one thing's for sure, you'd invite him back. It's worth noting that those who knew Jesus best always called him Jesus. The titles Jesus Christ, Lord Jesus, are only seen 6 times in the New Testament. Those who walked with Jesus and remembered him, they didn't have a title or designation. They just called him by his name, Jesus. Think about the implications of that. When God chose to reveal himself to people, what medium did he use? A book? Well, that's kind of secondary. A church? Definitely not. A moral code? No, you can't really say that, because to limit God's revelation to some simple do's and don'ts is as tragic to me as looking at a Colorado roadmap and saying, "I've seen the Rockies." When God chose to reveal himself, he did it in a human body. The tongue that called forth the dead was human. The hand that touched the leper and healed him probably had some dirt under the fingernails. The feet that the woman cried upon were probably calloused and dirty. And his tears, never miss the tears. They came from a heart as broken as yours and ours have ever been. The Bible says, "For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses." Jesus knew everyone, and he experienced them. He experienced everything we experienced except sin. So people came to him. Wow, did they come to him. They came at night. They touched him in the crowds on the street. They followed him all around the Sea of Galilee. They invited him into their homes, and they placed their children on his lap. Why? Because Jesus refused to be a statue in a cathedral or a priest in an elevated pulpit. He chose instead to be Jesus. There's not a hint of one single person who was afraid to be near him. There were those who mocked him. There were those who were envious of him. There were those who misunderstood him. And there were those who revered him. But there was no one that considered him too holy, too divine, too celestial to touch and to talk to. There wasn't one single person who was reluctant to speak to him, to approach him, because they thought he might reject them. Always remember that. Remember that the next time you feel embarrassed by one of your failures, or the next time nasty words have come out of your mouth or burned a hole in your soul, or the next time you see a cold church or a lifeless liturgy. Remember, it's us, people, who create the distance. It's Jesus who builds the bridge. Just call him Jesus, any time, any place. Amen. Favorite choruses. As we come to our time of prayer, I'd like to remind you of some of the concerns of our congregation. If you weren't here Christmas Eve and heard me say that our organist has COVID, that would explain Rob standing in this morning, and we really appreciate it. Thank you, Rob. So we're praying for Chris for a speedy recovery for sure. We're also continuing prayers for Jack Young, Vi Hannah, David McCann, Tracy Herring, Ken Heck, Patricia Zappone, Cynthia Mario, Kurt, Carol, Rachel, Judy, Ken, John, Edith, Ian, Bobby Mario's granddaughter Lexi, Fran, Chrissy Roche's father Ray, her sister Dawn and her husband Tim, Joanne DeJohn's friend Sharon, Christina and her little sons, and of course, Chris, which I already mentioned. Are there any other joys or concerns to share? Yeah, I think somebody's getting it. Let us join our hearts in prayer. God of glory, we thank you that we were able to celebrate the birth of your Son just one day ago. It continues to amaze us that the birth of this baby would change our world. Help us to live as people of grace, people who are changed because we have encountered the living God. Help us to be agents of change in the world around us, one person at a time. Dear God, we live in a troubled and fearful world. So many people are ill. So many people live in fear of a virus we cannot see, but is so real. O God, bring healing to our world. Bring us all back to health and wholeness. We want to be people who live in the light, not weighed down by darkness or fear or uncertainty. But sometimes that's difficult. Help us remember that your abiding love and mercy sustain us in times of fear. Our culture expects this to be a season of good cheer, but for some of us, the fears or loneliness can be overwhelming. Many of us sit in fear of the unknown, worrying about what will happen tomorrow. Some of us fear reports from doctors. Others fear a response or no response from family members. Whatever our fears and concerns, help us to remember that you are near us, that is the point of Emmanuel. You are with us. As we are about to enter a new year, may your hand be upon us. Let your love fill us. Let your joy overwhelm us. Let the melody of your love continue to ring in our hearts long after this year is finished, and then we can walk confidently into 2022 with the knowledge that we are always in your strong, powerful hands. We ask this in the name of your word made flesh, Jesus, who taught us all to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Please join me in singing number 249. There's a song in the air, verses 1 and 4. Place today, go with Christmas hope, because Christ is with us. May the Lord of light brighten your path, chase away any darkness, and by his presence bring you peace and joy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.